Hi there! In this tutorial, I will show you how to use a fill property to set the background style for elements. I will insert an element into the scene. In the properties pane, the fill section displays four values: no fill, solid fill, gradient fill, and image fill. The default value is solid fill. It defines a solid color for the background of the element. You can change the color by clicking the color button and selecting any color you want. You can also use the eyedropper to pick a color from anywhere within the application window. For example, I will pick the sand color. The color in the solid fill can be animated. Let's see how I animate the color of the div. Add starting keyframe first. And an ending keyframe with a different color, a green color. You can see the color turns from orange to green. Now look at the RGBI color picker. The default alpha is 255. You can drag the alpha slider to change its value. If alpha is 0, the background color becomes transparent. The next fill value is gradient fill. It is a multicolor fill in which one color gradually turns into another color. Gradient fill has two types, linear and radial, of which linear is a default. The gradient strip displays a line sample of the gradient. By default, it has two color points. One is black and the other is white. Click anywhere along the strip to add more color points. The selected color point has a red triangle at the top. You can use a color picker to change the color. You can also use the two buttons next to the strip to add more color points or to remove the selected color point. The position defines the position of a color along the strip. You can drag the color point or enter a new value to change the position. For the linear gradient fill, you can animate the angle. The angle here is formed between the horizontal line and the gradient line, so it defines the direction of the gradient. The next gradient fill type is radial. Here the shapes are in concentric circles starting from the center point. The shape parameter defines the shape. It can take the value ellipse or circle. The side param defines the size of the ending shape. There are four possible values. By default, farthest corner is selected. The origin X and origin Y define the location of the center point. For example, with origin X 50%, and origin Y 50%, the center point is center. While with origin X 0% and origin Y 0%, the center point is the top left, so the gradient starts at the top left with the background. Now we will discuss the image fill. This value fills the background of the element with an image. You can choose an image from the resources or from the computer. For the image fill, five fill options are available: stretch, center, fit, tile. And fill. For this element, I will choose center. The last fill value is no fill. When you choose no fill, the background of the element becomes transparent. So I've shown you all about the fill property. Hope that it helps. Bye for now.